the Anaheim Ducks would get another goal taken away from them versus St. Louis Blues last night. At least this one was actually the right call, as Carlsson was offsides. Guess the refs can see the blue line, but not the red line, meaning the Ducks have now had three goals taken away from them this year. And so has Earl Rakaninen, who had his first goal taken away for the third time in his career.
Look at that expression on his face. It's like, when is it going to happen?
And this is uncanny. I've never heard of anything like this before.
So yet again, the Ducks could not get the first goal of the game, as the Blues would answer quickly. Alex Killorn delivers his prettiest pass as a Duck to Sundqvist, who passes to Neighbors, and he scores. I have not been impressed with Killorn since his first game. The rest of the period would go more downhill for the Ducks, as they would be penalized for a Blues player falling on McTavish's stick in the faceoff circle. There was no penalty on the play, but after the review, they gave Mason 4 minutes for high sticking. I don't even know anymore, that's not a penalty. The Blues wouldn't score on that penalty, but they would score on the one that was called a few seconds after that, as Buchnevich is left all alone on the back door. In the second, they would add on, as the Blues would get a bounce off Vak's stick, and Torpchenko has a wide open net. So glad I'm done reading off St. Louis Blues players' names. Those are rough. The Ducks would answer finally, as Max Jones does great work on the forecheck, Killorn gets a little touch that springs McTavish, and he goes backhand to score. But that would be all she wrote, as the Ducks lose 3-1, as they couldn't get really anything going in the third. Now, three straight losses for the Ducks, who have only scored 4 goals in their last 3 games. The Ducks had chances to score more, but as Cronin has said numerous times, they don't shoot and nobody knows why. John Gibson was good yet again, and the score could have been worse. The Ducks had new lines in this one, and obviously they didn't work. Terry was dropped to the third line, and he might have to be dropped lower, because he is looking worse and worse every game. He keeps passing up shots and making careless passes. And at the end of the game, he was a forward sent out as a sixth attacker. Why is he getting rewarded for his play? Zegras was benched for doing less than what he's doing. The double standard is ridiculous. Max Jones, Mason McTavish, and Jakob Silfverberg were the standout players for me in this one. Jones was elevated to that top line and played a game full of energy. He made this diving play to Killorn to set him up on the break. That was a thing of beauty. He has put together a terrific stretches of games now. So glad the NHL rewarded him with an assist on the goal, because that was just a lot of hard work from him. McTavish continues to produce and is now tied for first on the team in points. Silfverberg has looked good in his last several games. His hips aren't lying, and he has been great on the forecheck and seems to be one of the only players willing to shoot. I don't even know what to say anymore. It's been the same thing the last several games. Cronin better not be giving the guys a day off with their 2 days off coming, because they have not earned it. The Ducks will now take on the Montreal Canadiens on Wednesday at 7 p.m. The Habs will also be coming in well-rested with 3 days off and a 4-game losing streak to break. They will be looking for their second win in November. Ducks need to set the tone from the jump and play a full 60. Make sure you like and subscribe, as we're trying to overtake the Anaheim Ducks official YouTube channel this season. Thank you for watching, and go Ducks!